From the construction of the most expensive oil field to an insane airport expansion. And from a massive nuclear power plant to the most advanced high-speed rail. Here are some of the biggest megaprojects on the planet. We start with number 5, Tel Aviv's light rail, which costs $20 billion. This is Israel's biggest public transportation project, and it comes at a staggering cost of $20 billion. It consists of 3 main rail lines, the red, green, and purple, which have a combined length of 90 kilometers. Together, they will accommodate 228 million passengers every year, and the first of the 3 is just days away from transporting its first passengers. But why is it being built? The Tel Aviv metropolitan area has actually needed such a megaproject for decades. Now, to understand this, you only have to look at how you can currently get from point A to point B in Tel Aviv. Either you take one of the slow buses, call an Uber, or, well, you walk. The city's growing population means that traffic is becoming more and more congested. For this reason, Israel has been considering a rail-based mass transit system since the 1960s. However, the unstable political situation and financing problems kept getting in the way. Fast forward 60 years, and Israel is finally working on this mass transit system. While most cities built these systems entirely underground, Tel Aviv's decided to go with a hybrid system that consists of both underground and above-ground sections. The first part of it is the 24-kilometer-long Red Line, which operates between Petah Tikva and Bat Yam. Half of the track runs through tunnels connecting 10 underground stations. This red line is the first step in a plan to completely change the way Tel Aviv travels. Over the next 5 years, the purple and green lines will also become part of the system. Moving on from underground rail tracks, we'll talk about a megaproject that will reshape air travel in one of the busiest cities in the world. Number 4, the Dubai Airport expansion, with construction costs of $33 billion. Dubai has developed into a global metropolis and the business center of the Middle East. As a result, more and more people from all over the world are traveling into the city. To manage this large number of travelers, Dubai now has 2 huge airports, the International Airport and the Al Maktoum International Airport. The latter is still relatively new, and so far only handles about 1.5 million passengers per year. But now it's getting a massive $33 billion makeover that will make it by far the world's largest airport in both physical size and passenger volume. To give you an idea of the insane scale of this expansion, here's a quick visualization. The airport's busiest year to date was 2019, when it handled about 1.6 million passengers. But once all 3 planned expansion phases are completed, its capacity will be 150 times higher. This would make it much bigger than the other Dubai International, and actually any other airport around the world. Construction is divided into 3 phases and will include 4 additional runways, 2 new terminals, 4 lobbies, and a cargo facility large enough to move 16 million tons of freight every year. A 40-kilometer road and metro network will also be built to make the airport more accessible. By the end of Phase 1, the annual passenger capacity is projected to increase to 130 million. Some reports cite 2030 as the completion year for this phase, but since the progress to date is only paperwork, a mid-2030s timeline seems more plausible. Phase 3 is expected to be completed by about 2050 and increase the capacity up to 255 million passengers. That's more than twice the size of the Atlanta airport, which is currently the largest in the world. But why is Dubai building such a large airport? I mean, if everything goes to plan, both cities' airports together would be able to handle over 350 million annual passengers, more than the total US population. The simple answer to this is the rapid evolution of Dubai into a megacity. The sheer number of travelers will eventually exceed the capacity of Dubai International, so another airport is Dubai's preemptive plan to deal with a major future challenge. But there's another factor at play here. Dubai's neighbor, Saudi Arabia, is also in the midst of a rapid transformation. As a part of that shift, Saudi Arabia has launched the master plan for King Salman International Airport in Riyadh. As things stand, this new airport will become the biggest in the Middle East, overtaking Dubai's current main airport. So, the Al Maktoum expansion will help Dubai to keep that title and protect its status as the business center of the Middle East. Next up, we have another massive expansion project, the likes of which haven't been seen in America for the last 30 years. Number 3, Plant Vogtle Reactor 3 and 4, costing $35 billion. This is the colossal construction site of a nuclear megaproject 14 years in the making. The project calls for the creation of two additional nuclear reactors at the Plant Vogtle facility in Georgia. Unit 3 finally began operation in July this year, and once the fourth reactor is completed, these two will generate a total of 2,200 additional megawatts of electricity, enough to supply about 500,000 households. But the story of how we got here starts way earlier. Plant Vogtle already had two existing reactors that began operating in 1987 and 89. For years, they remained the only two reactors at the facility, with a capacity of 2,450 megawatts. But over the years, it's become clear that coal and gas power plants won't be around forever. Beyond that, there are major challenges related to the reliability and storage problems of wind and solar energy. If done right, nuclear power plants can provide clean and reliable energy to millions of people. So in 2009, the state of Georgia decided to upgrade this plant, hoping to shift close to 3 million consumers to a source of energy with much lower CO2 emissions. When approved, the project was estimated to be operational by 2017 and cost $14 billion. However, construction was delayed even before the scheduled beginning in 2012. The nuclear accident at Japan's Fukushima reactor a year earlier led to increased safety protocols and licensing delays. Construction finally began a year later, and regulators decided to use innovative designs to speed up the process. That plan, however, backfired and led to even more licensing delays than expected. By 2015, the expansion was officially 3 years behind schedule, and the budget was adjusted to $22 billion. A few short years later, the project was massively affected by the pandemic. Worker schedules were shortened, which meant that the whole plan was pushed even more. Finally, in mid-2022, the Nuclear Regulatory Commission approved plans to load Reactor 3 with fuel. But of course, something went wrong again. Major flaws were found, which meant that the reactor's wiring had to be redone. So today, after 7 years of delays and a 250% cost increase, Georgia Power finally began operation of Unit 3 reactor last month. Meanwhile, Reactor 4 will be fully functional by early 2024. Despite the history of problems, state officials and stakeholders have called the expansion a major victory, as it will deliver clean electricity for the next 60 to 80 years. In contrast, our next megaproject is a massive oil field development, which might be the last of its kind. Number 2, the Kashagan oil field, at a cost of $50 billion. Oil is still one of the most sought-after commodities in the world, which is why states and private companies spend billions of dollars every year to find new oil fields. And in the year 2000, an exploration program in the Caspian Sea led to the discovery of one of the biggest oil reserves in the whole world. Located 80 kilometers off the shore of Kazakhstan, the Kashagan oil field holds 13 billion barrels of recoverable oil, enough to power the entire world for 5 months. Initially, the project was estimated to cost $10 billion. However, the Kashagan development proved to be very challenging. Oil lies 4.5 kilometers below the surface of the Caspian Sea. Temperatures often fall below negative 20 degrees Celsius here, forming a several meter thick coating of ice for months. Under these extreme weather conditions and because of the presence of ice, conventional offshore drilling technologies are no longer usable. To deal with the ice, 5 artificial islands were built to prevent direct contact and to provide a stable base for the drilling equipment. More than 5,000 workers remained on the artificial islands, where they worked in freezing temperatures to assemble the pipelines. These pipelines will transport the crude oil from the wells to processing plants on land. After a decade of construction and costs already over 4 times the original budget, the Kashagan oil field was finally ready to produce oil in September 2013. However, just weeks later, it was plagued with a major problem. The main pipeline couldn't handle the massive pressure and sprang a leak. This caused the entire project to be halted again and costs to spiral even further. Experts wondered how a $50 billion investment, 2 government-backed companies, and 4 of the biggest oil industry giants were failing to produce a single drop of oil. But this was not an isolated occurrence. Due to the massive scale of oil projects, delays and cost overruns are actually fairly common. An estimate from Chevron found that between 2007 and 2010, only 8% of oil megaprojects were on time and close to the estimated budget. After the debacle with the main pipeline, construction at Kashagan continued, and commercial output finally started 3 years later. Today, the field produces 400,000 barrels of oil per day. Overall, Kashagan oil field proved to be a complex project at a massive cost. As the world tries to decrease its dependence on fossil fuels, an oil megaproject of this scale may never be repeated. And now, we continue with the most expensive megaproject. If you enjoyed this video so far, help us reach the 1 million subscriber milestone and subscribe to Top Luxury. Thanks a lot for your help. Number 1. The Chuo Shinkansen, with an approximate cost of $80 to $100 billion. For our last megaproject, we head to Japan. Nearly 32 million tourists visit the so-called Land of the Rising Sun every year. But if you ask many of these travelers, you'll find that they're especially fascinated by one Japanese creation, the Shinkansen, or as the literal translation of the word goes, bullet train. This piece of infrastructure speaks volumes about Japanese efficiency. These trains are insanely fast, with speeds of up to 320 kilometers per hour. During 6 decades of operation, delays have remained a rarity, and there's never been a single injury on the Shinkansen due to an accident. And now, Japan is working on an extension that will break technological and speed barriers like never before. The new line will connect Tokyo and Osaka in just 67 minutes, with trains traveling at top speeds of over 500 kilometers per hour. To achieve these insane speeds, Japan is making use of maglev trains that hover slightly above the tracks with the help of magnets. Construction of the Chuo Shinkansen began in 2014 and will be developed in 2 phases. Phase 1 will connect Tokyo with Nagoya by 2027. This 344-kilometer stretch is a massive undertaking, as most of the route will pass through tunnels. Phase 2 will connect Osaka to the new line and is scheduled for completion in 2037. Whether Japan can meet the ambitious schedule remains to be seen. Do you know other megaprojects that we should cover in a future video? Let us know in the comments below. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you next time.